right, what's going on, everybody? It is Turkey Tuesday for me. That was the first thing that came to mind. But I didn't get a lot of sleep. I was watching Monday Night Football, and I'm dogged in a little, but been into these ladder workouts lately. They're just really simple to come up with and potent at the same time. So today is another couplet style workout. One machine and one piece of exercise equipment, a dumbbell. So real basic. I'm gonna be using my Echo bike. If you have a Salt bike, a Schwinn Airdyne, a rowing machine, something that uses arms and legs, preferably, I suggest using that. Worst case scenario, or a skier, worst case scenario, you can use a biker, a spin bike, the treadmill. You're gonna do a lot of upper body with the dumbbell, so it's okay, but if possible, try to find a machine that tracks calories and you use your arms and your legs there, full body. All right, so the workout, real simple. You're gonna start on the bike, 10 calories. You're gonna jump off the bike. It's 18 minutes long, by the way. AMRAP, as many rounds of reps as possible. If I said that already, again, it's because I'm sleepy. So you're gonna start with 10 calories on this puppy. Right when you're done with 10, you're gonna hop off, you're gonna do 8 alternating hanging dumbbell snatches. So you're gonna bring the dumbbell in between your legs here, watch your privates, and snatch it overhead. Okay, so some key components there is keep your core nice and tight, chest as high as you can, use your glutes to get that dumbbell moving from basically parallel to your arms parallel to the floor. Once it gets up there, you want to keep that arm nice and close to your body and make sure it's pressed overhead, okay? But again, keep your core tight, make sure your shoulders are warmed up, and it ends up being a really good workout. So you're going to do alternating. So you're going to start with 10 calories on the bike, 8 snatches. 12 calories on the bike, 10 snatches. 14 calories on the bike, what's the next one? 14 snatches. Or 12 snatches. I'll have it in the description below, but you're basically starting with 10 here, 8 here. You're increasing by 2 each round for each movement or machine. All right? So 10, 8, 12, 10, 14, 12, 16, 14, etc. All right? So kept it even numbers to make it easier with the math. And that's all she wrote. So get as many rounds or reps as possible, and you're done for the day. 18 minutes. No excuses. Let's get moving. Don't forget to warm up. Yep. All right. We have 18 minutes. Now we have 10 seconds before we begin. It's gonna stink. I'm ready, we did it. 12 counts. 10 snatches. All right, born to watch 14 cows and a white kid. Full snatch. Sixteen. Muy te va a cantar. Fourteen snatches. Eighteen cows. Wow. Sixteen. We're going to start breaking these up. Getting blisters. Six more. 18 snatches. It was Halloween last night. Way too much candy. Eight more. Minute left. Wow. Well, nothing like getting that heart rate up at 6 o'clock in the morning. All right, so machine work is pretty self-explanatory. The dumbbell snatches, slightly more complicated movement, but a potent one. But if you don't feel comfortable doing those, I would suggest doing a lighter weight, doing a dumbbell curling press. So you hammer curl, nice and isolated and controlled, press overhead, alternate arms, come bring it down, curl, press. That, or if you're comfortable doing kettlebell swings and you're using two arms, go as heavy as you can there. You could do Russian ones where your arms are parallel to the floor, or American standard where your elbows are through your ears, like that. Arms are perpendicular to the floor. But yeah, overall that was good. I finished the round of 22-20, which is further than I thought I'd get. So, good workout. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll put the whole workout in the description. Hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to stretch. Done.